Good morning, students. In last video, we had discussed about algorithm and flowchart. In this video, we are going to discuss about fundamental of object-oriented programming and Java. Let's start with the introduction of Java. James Gosling and his team had developed a Java programming language in 1994 at Sun Microsystems. In 2010, Oracle acquired Sun Microsystems and took over the development of the language. Today, Java version 12 is one of the most powerful and one of the most preferred languages of the industry to develop software applications, web services, and enterprise level applications. Java is an object-oriented language, which means that the developer need to define their code in terms of object and relationship among those objects. Now let's discuss about the Java compiler and interpreter. We already know that a translator is a program that converts the program written in any programming language into machine language that is executable by the computer. Java is machine-independent language. This means that programs written in Java run on all the computers without making any changes in the program for different machines. How is that possible? It is because Java works with two translators, compiler and interpreter. Program written in Java is first compiled by the compiler into a form that is understood by the interpreter of Java. This code is then converted by the interpreter into machine language for execution. The source code, that is a Java file, has extension .java. Compiler converts it into bytecode file with extension .class. Bytecode is translated by interpreter into machine language. This translation occurs line by line as the program runs. This is done by the software tool called Java Virtual Machine. Any computer having Java Virtual Machine can run Java bytecode. Now let's discuss about the object-oriented programming approach. Object-oriented programming approach is closer to real life. Programs are visualized and modeled in terms of object, just like the world around us is made of various objects. So let's first start with objects. Look around, everything is an object. The world around us, including us, is made of various objects. All objects have two major features, properties and behavior. For example, a vehicle has properties such as registration number, fuel, color, model, company, average fuel consumption, price, etc. And it shows behavior like start, stop, and it shows behavior like start, stop, turn, etc. Behavior depends on the properties. For example, vehicle will not start if fuel is not there. Now next is classes. A class defines the properties and behavior of the objects. Object of similar properties and behavior belong to the same class. For example, all the vehicles can be kept under a class vehicle. Once class is defined, as many objects of that class can be created. As object in instance of its class. In the figure shown here, object 1, object 2 and object 3 of class vehicle shows some properties and behavior. Like registration number, color, model, company, price and their behavior like start, stop, turn. In the object 1, the registration number is given RJAB1 X4, color red, model Desire, company Maruti, price 5,70,000. And object 2, see, he's also given some details about the vehicle, Honda Amage. So these are the objects which of the class vehicle. It means the objects of similar properties and behavior belongs to same class. Hence, a class is a blueprint of objects to be created in future, just like a map of a house. Now let's see features of Java programming language. Latest version of Java at the writing of this latest version of Java is 12. Java programming language has following major features. Java is platform independent. Its programs are set to be write once, run anywhere, since they can run on any operating system and hardware. Java is absolutely object-oriented programming language. New changes in programs can be easily done without affecting other parts of the program. Java virtual machine is capable of executing multiple tasks at the same time. Java is most suitable to run over a network due to its network capabilities. Java provides a vast library of developed software, apps and web services. Any exceptional situation during programming execution is handled efficiently to prevent the program from crashing. Java programs are not prone to malware or viruses since they run in secure runtime environment under JVM. Java programs run faster. Java programs are compiled into bytecode and then bytecode is run by Java virtual machine interpreter quickly. Now let's see some object orientation concept. First, abstraction and encapsulation. Tendency to look for what is necessary is called abstraction. When an adult goes to buy a motorbike, he or she looks more for performance, like fuel consumption of the bike, then it's being trendy and stylish, while a teenager will look for just reverse, style first. So the two people look for different details in the same object. This is abstraction. We see what we want to see. Then what is encapsulation? The service provider hides the function and feature which are not meant for customers and explore only those features which are necessary. For example, when we make a call on our smartphone, do we bother how that call is being connected? No. We are just concerned that we would be able to dial a number or select the contact to call and call must connect. A smartphone provides the necessary feature to do that exactly. This is encapsulation. Encapsulation just provides what we need and hides what we don't. Hence, encapsulation is a tool to implement abstractions. Next one is inheritance. In real life, children inherit the features and traits of their parents, such as facial features, voice, hair, etc. Similarly, in object-oriented programming, if programmer is going to create a new class and want to use certain features like property and behavior of already existing class, then he will inherit the new class with the existing class. Then the programmer can just add the features which are new in the new class. Inherited class is called subclass or extended class or child class, while the existing class from which the new class is inherited is called parent class or base class. Next one, polymorphism. The term polymorphism has two parts. Poly means many and morphous means forms. When an object behaves in different way in the same or changing scenario, then it is said to be showing polymorphic behavior. For example, a printer can give printout on various types and sizes of paper. Polymorphism refers to an object behaving differently in different context. The next one, Java data types. Data type define the type and size of the value to be stored. Java has basic data types as well as inbuilt predefined data types. Basic data types are associated with a specified size they occupy in the memory. They are also called primitive data type. Following are the primitive data types in Java. First, numbers and float. Numbers could be whole number, positive or negative numbers, or numbers with decimal places. Numbers with decimal places are called floats. Here are some data types. For the integer category, there are four data types available here: byte, short, integer, long. Byte occupy one byte in size, short 2 bytes, integer 4 bytes, long 8 bytes. For the floating numbers or real numbers, there are two data type which given here. Float, that occupy 4 bytes in memory, and double for 8 bytes. Here the floating numbers will display with their decimal places. Here the precision of floating point value indicate how many digits the value can have after the decimal point. The precision of float is only 6 or 7 decimal points, whereas the precision of double is 15 decimal digits. Next one, the Boolean data type. It can take only the value true and false. Next one, characters, that stores single character. A character must be surrounded by single quotes. Next one, string type. A string is not a primitive data type. It is an inbuilt type of Java. It is the most frequently used non-primitive data type. It is used to store a sequence of letters called strings. Values to be stored must be enclosed within double quotes. For example, a string student underscore name equal to Rashina. It must be enclosed, the value must be enclosed within double quotes. And note that data type name begins with a capital S in a string. Next one, Java variables. Program store the data of running program in the memory. Such memory locations are identified as variables. A variable is a location in the memory where program stores the data. In the program, variables are identified by unique names. While program runs, the value in the variable may change, hence they are called variables. The names of variable classes and functions are also called identifiers. Here is some variable naming conventions. The name of the variable should suggest that what kind of data it is storing. For example, if a variable is going to store age, then it can be named as age. Variable name should be relevant and short. A variable name may begin with a letter or alphabet or underscore or dollar sign. Variable name may contain a number but should not begin with number. A variable name should not have spaces or special characters except underscore and dollar sign. The keyword used in Java cannot be used as a variable names. Java is case sensitive language, hence variable with same name but different cases of letter are considered a separate variable. So these are some naming convention of variable in Java. That's all for today. Thank you.